talking. I feel like that's what's been like my main like go-tos. So I'm gonna make my own record collection video. I think I already have one or two posted already, but I guess this will be like part three or whatever we're on. But yeah, let's just get right into it. So I hope I haven't shown any of these. This is Gus Dapperton, and the name of this album is Orca. I think I've shown this before. I'm pretty sure I've shown this before. I hope not, but I have a feeling that I've shown it before. But anyways, yeah, I think this is the first album that I like from start to finish of his. I feel like he's really good at putting out singles, but when it comes to making an entire like album, it just doesn't come out great. So I definitely feel like this is like one that he executed pretty well, and I like every song on this album. When I first got into it, I listened to the album from start to finish for like a couple weeks straight. The songs on this record are Bottle Opener, First Aid, Post Humorous, Bluebird, Palms, My Say So, Grim, Antidote, Medicine, and Swan Song. Story as to like why he named the album Orca, and I think it's because like if you look at like the like orcas that are in like what is that, SeaWorld, they're really sad, they're just caged, they're not really going anywhere, and I think he related to them in that sense. But yeah, and then this was just printed on black wax, so there's nothing crazy about the record itself. So moving on, I'm gonna make this one short. I feel like I have shown this one before. Probably shouldn't have started with this one. I'm starting to think I've shown all of these. I know I showed Jubilee, the newest album of hers, but this is Soft Sounds from Another Planet by Japanese Breakfast. This is Michelle Sonar. Front woman, everything. I love her. I'm obsessed with her. I got to see her a year ago at a music festival, and I was just, it was the best of times. And she also came out with a book called Grind in H-Mart. I strongly recommend it. It's beautiful. It's a memoir. I literally cried a lot. There are times I was crying so hard I like legit had to stop reading. About that. This is Japanese Breakfast with Soft Sounds from Another Planet. I really like this album. I think, I don't know, I want to say Diving Woman is probably my favorite song on here, but the tracks on this record are Diving Woman, his house, and here comes the tubular bells. Yeah, I love this. I think this is her second album. Her first album is Psycho Bombed, and I haven't been able to get my hands on that, which makes me sad. Yeah, it's beautiful. I think this album, the first album she came out, was like her dealing with like her mom passing away from cancer. I know Psycho Bump was like she recorded like right after her mom passed away. Tame Impala record, and this is just a live recording of a handful of songs, and it's Indoors Toi, Why Won't You Make Up Your Mind, Sestri Levante, Mind Mischief, which is my personal favorite of all time, Desire Be, Desire Go, A Half Full Glass of Wine, Be Above It, Feels Like We're Only Going Backwards, and Apocalypse Daydream. It's pretty cool. You can hear people clapping, and like he talks in between like sets. It's really cool. And then this is also just pressed on black wax, nothing crazy. This is your speaker. His first one. Tame Impala Lonerism. show is Kieran's. But this is his newest one. The Slow Rush. Honestly, there's a lot of people that did not like this album, but I actually really enjoyed it. Lost in Yesterday.
What's the other one?
Is Patience not on this?